distance in from the walls. Some of the main components that we use in our power supply are TI, DLP, and 202, as the fire does use, so the super cap is a triple bus number, and that very aero, carbon aerobale capacity. We've got the smart battery charger, everything in our library, to make sure it doesn't charge nickel cadmium or alkaline, we have to check for that. And we've got some other parts that are in the library for power availability and our overall users and high efficiency chips as well. Our other electrical components, we use as out switching, using three transistors and a couple of reservoir capacitors. And I also did the Arduino clone on the PCB itself, and that is in circuit programmable.
Alright, so I was in charge of the packaging mostly. And we designed that as a top and bottom enclosure. The top enclosure houses all of our electronics, PCB, and the interface. And the bottom enclosure houses the valve, the motor, and the battery. They both have to be completely waterproof because it's going to be outside of it. Some of the features of the enclosures that we have dimensional stability, thermal stability, impact resistance, mold release, UV resistance, and it's easily accessible. That's four screws you can open easily, and it's also very weatherproof. Our solar panels were housed in a modified picture frame, basically just dipped in epoxy so it can be waterproof. And our current design is copied using silicone frame. And for our functionality, pretty much we have inputs from the solar panel that goes through the power supply into the batteries, into the condition to the circuit, to the microprocessor. The microprocessor outputs to the controller valve and takes in data from the sensors. It also opens the user interface and takes in user input. Some of our functional specifications are has to connect to the 3/4-inch standard nose fitting. It must operate on a temperature range of 0 to negative 40 degrees Celsius. We have a survivability range of negative 50 degrees. Our AA nickel metal hydride batteries can fully charge for dead in 30 minutes. And we have 3 liters of the water patterns as body stages. And we also have on-demand wiring and a developer and initial service available to the server for the program. Which means a user can put their own code in the system. And last is low power switch gate.
The budget, we went way over, a little bit over. We bought a lot of parts that didn't end up coming in the final prototype.
Let's thank our team. Team, I'd like to begin with questions. Did you test your soil moisture sensor? Did you test the whole system as a whole?
The system as a whole?
Yes.
The system is non-functional.
So what parts of the system are functional?
The software was able to be demoed and signals looked right when we out of the LEDs, we just used that to deploy the system. Soil moisture was read in accurately. We had two pots down in the senior design lab, a wet case and a dry case. We could accurately tell the difference between the two.
Power supply provides the 5 volts and 12 volts. Well, the valve switching has problems. The stage switch doesn't perform as well.
What kind of valve did you end up with?
We ended up with a valve that we named out of another different line. It's something they custom engineered. And we looked at a number of solenoid and solenoid valves mostly. We didn't find anything that would fit on par with them. So we ended up taking this, which is a little motor that flips a little plunger. It basically like has a weird valve feedback system.
So questions from our audience?
You talked a little bit about the sleep state a couple of times, and I'm kind of curious to actually know how you actually implemented that. Is it hardware, hardware in the sleep state, or is it something you're doing with software where you're just basically sitting on idle?
It's in software. It's a power reduction mode, really. The Arduino allows for several different sleep states or power saving modes. We picked one that just had very minimal features enabled. Timer is all we really needed when it was sleeping, so it could wake up by itself, as well as interrupts. And we turned off things like ADD and some unnecessary timers.
Gotcha. Did you see any kind of, I mean, I know you said this system was like this employee function, but did you notice any power reduction or anything?
The micro actually gets hot when it's on full mode, and we were keep on continuously when it cools down. So it's avoided by a power reduction.
Probably good.
It's not a wait for too long.
So questions from
I have a question on your soil moisture sensor. Did you look at, you know, the you obviously had to set some sort of threshold to determine if the soil is wet or no, it's not. Did you use experimental data to do this, and did you look at different types of soils that might be available? I mean, or was this sort of just an ad hoc adjustment?
We didn't look into different types of soils, and we didn't think of thresholds for different types of plants that different plants might require, but we did experimentally determine what values multimeters and what was a wet case and what was a dry case.
So you got to put your finger into the term, yeah, this is wet, and then therefore it does this.
Pretty much.
This is more a team question. You each talked about the areas that you were responsible for. As a team, how did you work independently and then expect things to come back together? What design mechanisms or handshakes and agreements did you have so that the, say, soil moisture threshold information would work when it was finally connected to the processor?
There's a lot of yelling involved.
Yelling?
Yeah.
That was one of the hard part of trying to do, actually integrating all our subsystems together and
the design side of the communications building. Some stuff worked out, some stuff didn't.
So did you have any internal specs or interface agreements among yourselves?
Yes. Some were violated and some were followed. Different problem.
Yes, what would you do differently if you had to start this project over again?
I would test a lot earlier. Mm-hmm.
We missed our test and deadlines with our DCBs by a matter of a couple of days. So I get those things done a little earlier so we can test on actual hardware or paper.
That would be the days where we produce a functional prototype.